Did Iran really just ditch GPS for Beidou? That's the question dominating headlines right now. As usual, bold fonts, flashy thumbnails, zero depth. So we did some digging because once again, sensationalism beats substance, but the truth is that this so-called breaking news is actually a long-time move in a slow strategic game that has been unfolding for nearly a decade, and it could reshape global power. Today, we are laying out the real timeline of Iran's navigation switch. We will reveal why this move threatens US military supremacy and how China's master plan is already working in over 100 countries worldwide. By the end, you will have a clearer view of what's really changing and why this shift matters more than most people realize. Here is what the sensational headlines won't tell you about Iran's Beidou adoption. This strategic shift didn't happen yesterday or last month. This carefully orchestrated move began in October 2015. That's when Iran officially started adopting China's Beidou satellite positioning system. Back then, Iranian media explicitly reported that China would establish Beidou ground stations throughout Iran. Iran Electronics Industries, the country's largest electronics conglomerate, would manage Beidou services nationwide. Why this massive undertaking? Because the US had previously prohibited Iran's access to high-precision services from GPS. Iran was essentially navigation blind for military purposes. Beidou promised to cover all blind spots across the country where GPS couldn't reach. Fast forward to January 2021. Iran's ambassador to Beijing publicly announced that China would provide Iran with its new global positioning system. He called it a solid foundation for expanding new relations between the two countries. Then came the bombshell in April 2021. China and Iran signed a historic 25-year comprehensive strategic cooperation agreement. This wasn't just about navigation systems. The agreement included three earth-shaking components. First, China committed to investing $400 billion in Iran's energy and infrastructure. Second, oil and trade transactions would be settled in Chinese currency, not US dollars. Third, Iran would install China's Beidou system for its missile arsenal. This transformed Iran from a regionally constrained power to a precision strike capable adversary. The 2021 agreement formalized cooperation, but the technological relationship started 6 years earlier. This wasn't a sudden pivot during recent crises. This was a gradual, methodically planned strategic alignment unfolding for nearly a decade. Why would Iran commit to such a massive partnership with China? The answer lies in three critical vulnerabilities threatening the nation's survival. First, crippling US sanctions have systematically strangled Iran's economy. Countries are prohibited from conducting oil transactions with Iran using traditional banking systems. If US dollars are involved, banks face severe secondary sanctions. By settling oil trade in Chinese currency, Iran can bypass these restrictions entirely. Second, relying on US-controlled GPS creates dangerous strategic vulnerabilities during military conflicts. Iran has never dared to use US and European Union navigation systems for its missile systems precisely because of signal cutoff risks. In 1993, the US accused a Chinese ship of carrying banned weapons to Iran. They cut off its GPS access. The ship drifted for weeks, and after inspections, no weapons were found, but China never forgot. Third, surveillance and cyber vulnerabilities pose existential threats. The assassination of Iranian General Soleimani by precision-guided drone highlighted these surveillance risks. Breaking dependence on Western-dominated digital systems became a matter of national survival.
Just this week, Iran's parliament voted to ban Starlink satellite internet. Users could face fines, jail, even flogging. It's the latest move in Iran's fight to control digital access and reflects rising fears of Western tech during wartime.
From a military perspective, BeiDou adoption fundamentally transforms Iran's offensive capabilities. Iran previously lacked effective navigation systems for its extensive missile arsenal. Installing BeiDou significantly improves targeting accuracy for ballistic missiles. Iran maintains missiles with ranges exceeding 2,000 kilometers, capable of hitting most Middle Eastern countries and US military bases. With BeiDou integration, Iranian drones, missiles, and air defense systems now operate with enhanced precision using encrypted coordinates. The system's advanced anti-jamming capabilities provide battlefield resilience against cyber attacks and electronic warfare. Before we keep going, quick ask, hit like, share this with someone curious, and drop a hi in the comments. It helps more than you think and keeps real stories like this on your feed. China's eagerness to provide BeiDou technology to countries like Iran isn't charitable goodwill. It's part of an ambitious strategy to challenge US technological dominance worldwide. The 1991 Gulf War profoundly shocked Chinese military leadership. They witnessed GPS-enabled, highly accurate, precision-guided weapons that devastated Iraqi forces. The 1996 Taiwan Strait crisis became the final trigger. China realized its military was blind compared to US forces, entirely dependent on a navigation system America could cut off instantly. China recognized that the power that controls space controls the battlefield. This realization sparked massive investment. China spent over $12 billion launching 55 satellites over 26 years to establish the complete BeiDou constellation. Completed in 2020, BeiDou now serves as what Chinese sources call a great and powerful weapon providing global positioning capabilities. Economically, BeiDou serves multiple strategic purposes. As the world's largest oil importer, China faces enormous costs from US dollar dependence. China's daily settlement volume through SWIFT reaches $200 or $300 billion. Handling fees alone cost China from $7.3 to almost $11 billion annually. Using Chinese currency for settlements saves China billions every year. China's satellite navigation industry reached $79.9 billion in 2024, growing 7.4% year over year. China has filed over 129,000 navigation-related patents, making it the global leader. Here is the strategic element. BeiDou works like GPS. It's free for everyday users in China and worldwide, but China adds premium features like messaging and precision tools for advanced users. That's how it grows adoption and influence. BeiDou serves as a central pillar in China's One Belt, One Road infrastructure initiative. More than 100 of the 137 countries that signed Belt and Road agreements now use BeiDou most frequently. Over 30 countries in Africa use BeiDou for precision agriculture, boosting crop yields by over 15%. By providing BeiDou to partners like Iran and North Korea, China extends its military influence globally. This fundamentally alters regional military balance. Chinese commentators view the Iran partnership as containing US military deployments in the Middle East, while paving the way for China's expansion in the Taiwan Strait and South China Sea. The global navigation landscape is no longer America's monopoly. BeiDou has emerged as a serious GPS competitor with distinct advantages. Constellation size tells the story. BeiDou operates from 45 to 50 satellites compared to GPS's 31 satellite. BeiDou also maintains significantly more ground stations worldwide. Accuracy comparisons reveal BeiDou's superiority in many regions. For civilian services, BeiDou offers 1 meter positioning accuracy in Asia, China, and Africa. Some reports suggest BeiDou outdoes GPS accuracy in over 165 countries. For military applications, BeiDou achieves centimeter-level accuracy. GPS typically provides 3-5 meter accuracy. Current GPS 3 satellites improve this to 1 meter, but still less than BeiDou's performance. BeiDou's unique features set it apart completely. The short message communication feature allows users to send text or location data without cellular coverage. This proves critical for emergencies, remote areas, and battlefield scenarios. GPS offers no comparable communication functionality. Control creates the biggest strategic difference. GPS operates under US military control, meaning access can be cut off during conflicts. BeiDou offers a secure, independent network that cannot be degraded or cut off by the United States. China aims to make BeiDou the world's go-to navigation system by 2035. The next major GPS upgrade isn't expected until the mid-2030s, giving BeiDou significant competitive advantages. If Iran's BeiDou adoption isn't new, why did it suddenly dominate headlines during recent tensions? This reveals how modern information warfare operates. Crisis situations amplify tension on military capabilities, even when underlying facts are years old. The narrative of Iran making swift moves emphasizes perceived defiance. Complex geopolitical shifts get condensed into oversimplified headlines. Iran ditches GPS for BeiDou, grabs attention, but masks years of strategic planning. Confirmation bias drives audiences seeking explanations for unfolding events. Recent presentation trumps actual chronological significance. Understanding the true timeline reveals deeper currents of global transformation. This represents strategic realignment away from US-dominated world order toward multipolarity. China's digital influence extends through comprehensive alternatives to Western systems. The digital Silk Road has profound implications for global trade and security. Independent navigation systems fundamentally alter warfare calculations. Adversaries gain precision capabilities independent of US control. More countries will likely follow Iran's example as tensions escalate. Nations face pressure to choose sides in the emerging technological Cold War. Did Iran really just ditch GPS for BeiDou? The answer depends on your time horizon and understanding of strategic patience. Iran didn't ditch GPS on a whim. It was pushed out. What looks like a switch is really a survival response, nearly a decade in the making, beginning in 2015 and expanding in 2021. China's BeiDou isn't simply a GPS alternative. It's a cornerstone technology in an emerging global order challenging Western technological hegemony. The next time dramatic headlines capture your attention, ask yourself, is this really happening now, or is there a deeper story? Critical media literacy has never been more important. The most significant geopolitical shifts often occur gradually, away from public attention. What do you think about these long-term power shifts reshaping our world? Will more countries abandon GPS for BeiDou as tensions escalate? Share your thoughts in the comments below. Thanks for watching.